Stephen Watkins hasn't seen his two young sons since they were allegedly abducted in 2009. It was 2 years ago today that 7-year-old Alexander and his 4-year-old son Christopher crossed the border into the U.S. with their mother. They flew from Rochester to Detroit, then on to Frankfurt, Germany, and they haven't been seen since. Police issued a Canada-wide warrant for their mother. Stephen knows her as Adita Watkins, but she may go by several other names. Right now, Stephen is here in our studio, and so is Detective Constable Jesse Mann from the York Regional Police Department. This has been an excruciating 2 years for you.
Oh, it's been very, very difficult emotionally and trying to get the word out.
You had to quit your job.
I was already not working because I was taking care of the boys and because they had been diagnosed with postpartum depression and autism as well. Alexander had high-functioning autism that was diagnosed.
So, taking you back just a little bit, there was marital troubles that you had had. You'd been in and out of the courts for custody and for that kind of thing. And then, at some point, you filed a missing person or went to police and said that you were worried that they were going to be abducted before they were abducted.
I didn't go to the police, actually. No, there was lots of signs and clues that told me that there was a chance that they were going to be highly abducted. And going through the court system, when you have parental alienation happening, that's a clue. And obviously if there's a threat, because I had a threat, that I would never see my boys again, so that's another clue. So I did contact Child Fund Ontario and asked them what to look for, and they educated me in advance and told me the proper procedures.
I guess some of the difficulty, Detective, involves the fact that we are now looking at, I mean, you're involved as a lead detective on this, but it's an international investigation.
It is.
So what kind of cooperation have you received?
Well, I think with any international investigation, there's obviously challenges and hurdles that have to be overcome. The obvious ones being language barriers, distance, and so on and so forth. But as well, just the making use of the appropriate channels, communication channels, through RCMP, Interpol, and then onwards to the Polish authorities.
And Polish authorities, because you believe, or everything in the investigation so far points to the fact that she may be there with the children.
Indeed, yeah. Yeah, it's difficult then to engage or to determine how engaged the Polish authorities are, because all the information goes through these appropriate channels, RCMP, Interpol, and then to the Polish authorities, they will conduct the search that's requested or the information being requested, and then it's forwarded back by those same channels. So it's a little difficult to determine, again, how engaged they are.
But you're not necessarily further ahead at this point in the game in terms of tracking them down, because in order to get the actual help you need, you'd have to find them first, right?
Yes, we need to find them first. And that's what makes it very, very difficult. And not only that, this is a unique case where there was so much research done in advance to their abduction. Letters were written to the government, to Passport Canada. The court procedures were done. As far as even the interior government canceled their Canadian passport and a driver's license. So what this ended up doing is exposing a major border security problem where you can enter the United States on all canceled documents, get on a plane and fly away.
The building blocks for her trip out seemed to be, as I was reading through the history, the children were taking Polish language lessons. Your ex-wife spoke Polish and a number of other languages as well.
Yes.
And so that was part of your fear as to where they were going. Tell me, in the 2 years, has the children's grandfather, who lives here, your ex-wife's father, has he had any contact, or has he said that he's had any contact?
I haven't spoken to him in 2 years. His lines are disconnected and hasn't reached out to me. And obviously there's an ongoing investigation, so
how do you move through your days without your kids?
It's so difficult. Like, you can't imagine not knowing where they are, if they're alive. I mean, we see all these things in the news. There's a lot of parental abductions, 99% of them. But we know it's capable of things, bad things happening, right? So finding them is really important to see where they are they safe, you know.
Which is why you're here today, too,
yes.
Is to try to raise awareness. I know you're going to be using social networking as well. We can certainly have all of those links. We'll have them on our website if anybody has any information that could possibly help you. Thank you for
coming
in. Thank you both of you.
Thank you
very much.
Take care.
Thank you.
So as I mentioned, there is a link to Stephen's website, and that's on our website, canadam.ctv.ca. We'll be right back.